I am very sorry, and I apologize for the inconvenience of me not giving up. And I'm swerving in the streets, got you nervous. All how to get it.
Southern woman sit on my lap. My favorite type of people when I take them out to ride for the first time are the overconfident people, because they're the ones that are like, oh yeah, I'm not even afraid of the horse. In fact, I'm gonna run on them. And I'm over here like, you know, okay, bud, you sure will. And then they get on the horse and I see them looking a little more like, oh Jesus, oh Buddha, oh Lord, oh mama, please get me off this thing. But you know what is funny? My family actually has this little handful of iconic jokes. Like whenever we talk about them, we just be rolling on the floor laughing. Like this one from my little sister when she was 5 years old. She said, why couldn't the pig get in the mud? Cause there was a tree in the way. I want you to want me, but you just wanna love
me for the day. This freak ass need his ass whooped. Nobody fucking with the shit he talking about.
All right, I'm about to race Ducati. Ready? Mark, set, go! She's dangerous, super bad. Better watch out, she'll take your cash. She's a gold digger.
Yo no soy ni voy a ser tu bizcochito. Pero tengo todo lo que tiene delito. Que me pongan en eso que me derrito. El mal de ojo que me mando me lo quito. Ya no soy un idiota, soy tu bizcochito. Pero tengo todo lo que tiene delito. Que me pongan en eso que me derrito. El mal de ojo que me mando me lo quito.
If you don't think a 600-pound animal running 55 miles per hour and eating carrots out of your hand is pretty amazing.
Let's also not forget that they're flight animals, which means that if they don't want to be around you, they're going to try their best to not be around you. But if you cool enough with them where they gravitate towards you, I can't give y'all an example because I just went for a ride, but literally just go through my feed. Powerful. You know what? I'm going to keep the freckles filter on because it came on and I just always wanted to look like this. But I'm going to be for real with y'all. Is jealous the right word? No. Envy. I'm very envious of y'all that have like training in different disciplines. Yes, my eyelashes fell off. So, but anyways, yeah, I'm envious of y'all that know how to do different disciplines, because even though I don't compete and I don't make money off of the stuff that y'all be doing, I would be having so much friggin' fun. Shango, not now. For example, I grew up in a ranch roping, a team roping household. And my favorite breed of horse is the miniature horse. I had Twilight. I was like, yo, let me go make myself a team roping horse. I made Twilight a header. Of course, it was my not so proudest moment and I regret it. But like, I did that. Do you know how much friggin' power and fun I would have knowing how to do these different disciplines that y'all do for competition and money? I would kill for a reining mini. I would kill for a cutting mini. And I'm trying to think of like a English event, because you know, we already do hunter jumper and driving events for minis. What else can we do? Some of y'all get some dressage ponies. I want a dressage mini. And I mean, I have my driving reins and I'm pretty quick and nimble. So shoot, barrel racing mini. So if any of y'all that like know how to do all these different disciplines, y'all want to tap in, because I'm trying to have some fun.
Yeah, y'all see him in the comments. He's thankful for the opportunity. I changed that bitch ass nigga life. Whole ass nigga. That nigga don't know how to fucking read.
Girl, you'll never believe what happened. Billy and his ugly friend, they made a phone call during the week. And I only have a limited amount of weekday minutes. That's so evil, man.
So where are you from?
London.
No. Where are you from? Oh, Tower Hamlets.
No, where did you come from?
Royal London Hospital, Whitechapel.
All right, I get it, fine. You're all without fathers, all right?
I'm not. I love my dad.
What's good, everybody? I'm being real sneaky right now because I'm trying to sneak up on Ducati. And I'm gonna call him real quick. He's right over here. Where's Ducati? Where'd he go? Wait. There he is. Where's that show? No, that's him.
He's got a big booty, so I call him Big Booty. Come here, you little nasty. Y'all see me? I'm gonna wait one more time. He's got a big booty, so I call him Big Booty. Little nasties don't know where I'm at. He's got a big booty, so I call him Big Booty.
He found me. Hey, what's up, everybody? What's up, Big Body? Hi, Chongo. Hi, Papa Beer. Hi, baby.
I guess I'm still doing now what I'm doing then. Chasing you like a shot of whiskey. Burning, going down. Burning, going down. Chasing you like those goodbye taillights. Headed west, anywhere out of this whole town. Chasing that freedom. Chasing that feeling that got gone too soon. Chasing that you and me.
My son Ducati, and we're gonna cosplay as if we went for a ride. This is because my gramps is old school and only sees a horse's value through their youth. I'd rather let all his backbones mature before riding him. So instead, we're gonna do groundwork until he's old enough. He already threatened to sell him because he never sees me ride. Yet I tell him I ride him all the time, and he's just never home when I do. I could be lying though, but it's all for his benefit. Most of the horse world is like this. I don't blame them because of the culture, but most believe 2 years old is of age. That's why my gram sees wasted potential. Yet my educated eye sees a little niggle. Here's to lying for the greater good.
You could gaze into the future. You might think life would be a breeze. See trouble from a distance, yeah. Go right. But it's not that easy. Take it to the switch. I try to see the situation, then I end up misbehaving. Oh, oh, oh. Hey now, say now, about to put it down. Yeah, come on and ride with the right hand. And if the future looks great now, then everything's gonna change now.
That's me.
stab me with them big old dark sienna brown eyes.
Yeah, y'all didn't think I was musically inclined. I'm good, you can tell.
Looked at me with them big old dark sienna brown eyes.
Yeah, y'all didn't think I was musically inclined. I'm good, you can tell.
Head wrap on fleek with them jeans holding in them bloody thighs. Oh my, we chopped it up. Talking about going to club. But girl, you said, no, I'd rather ride in the moonlight. And I was like, yes, this girl finna be the best. Little did I know, after this, you'd be all mine. Brown skinned girl, you are the world. Won't you just sprinkle black girl magic on me?
And I'm not even good, so I know y'all. When I tell you that I got dragged across the yard by an Andalusian filly. I think she's like 4 or 5 months old. She huge. I don't care what any of y'all got to say. She big. And like I said, she did it not once, but she did it twice. And I held on. So I just want to give a big shout out to my daddy for making me work out since middle school. I want to give a big shout out to all my track coaches because I kept up with her. Who else do I want to shout out to? I want to shout out to the dude who sold me these boots, my flea market 11s. Yeah, they had no grip, but you kept me grounded.
It's a wop. Three ropes in this ring, diving off the top. Throw that pussy at me, I'ma beat it out the box. Levita in this bitch, I got the city on lock. Ayy, ratchet bitch, she a South Central baddie.
Ooh.
About to bust her down. I'm just waiting on the addy.
Yeah, I drink the Julio, but do they get it gushy? You know I've been on the edge, so you can never push it. Bitches say they at my neck in person, they be pussy. If my ass so small, why your nigga always looking?
It's too long. As you twerk, yeah, she fooled me. So darling, darling, twerk, roll me, roll, twerk.
Interpret their names into their daughters? Or we just gonna name our daughters after shit that we like?
This is such a flattering angle of me, but picture this.
Partying like it's 1999.
You're a heavily pregnant lady about to give birth.
Birth to a biracial child at that. And who are the most famous family-friendly biracials at this time? Tia and Tamara. You're already pushing and planning on naming this child Tamara.
But wait, hold on, stop, wait a minute. You are out here pushing and already planning on naming one of your biracial children after one of the most popular biracial twins, and your husband comes in and he's talking about,
hey, you know who Desmond Howard is, right?
Walk that drink, walk that drink, walk that drink.
Blacked out, blurred, but I'm pretty sure it rules. Damn.
Here comes the hurricane, bitch. Here comes the hurricane, bitch. Here comes the hurricane, bitch. Here comes the hurricane, bitch.
I cannot do, I cannot do, I cannot do, I cannot do.
What is the cowboy hat rule?
What's the rule? I really want to know. What's the
little girl, what you doing? Hey, cowgirl Flojo outside.
Genuine attempt to being a baddie. I got some nails. They sure ain't no acrylics. They some $7 press-ons I got from Walmart, but there's a reason why I did that. To me, nails are like makeup, where you don't need them and you can still look good, but sometimes there's a certain outfits and situations where it's like, yep, putting this on will eat it up. Real talk, I actually want to buy like the little custom nails that y'all be selling online, but I have some reasons as to why I'm not just jumping in on it, and also why I decided to buy some $7 ones. I work outside, and not only do I work outside, but I'm often lifting heavy things. I'm in dirt and booty mess a lot, and I work with 1,000-pound animals. Now, there are some people who can do that, but on top of that, I haven't adapted to using these. These are so friggin' hard, dude. I cannot type on the phone for the life of me. I keep jamming it because I'm so used to using my fingertips and not my finger pads. Y'all, you can ask my homeboy because he was there with me. I started crying because I was like, I don't know how to wipe my ass. Anyways, I'm about to go to work in a little bit and we're going to see how long these last. I'm going to tell you right now, one nail is already starting to fall off, but that's just because I glued it on wrong. But we finna find out. I broke a nail putting on a halter. It's not even the one that I thought was going to break off.
I took them all off. And I did it for my own solidarity. My own sanity. See? It's already what?
I do not care that you say that you old. You all finna learn today.
So, everything was pretty much like on the fly. I just knew I had some key moves. The first one was going to be the wop, wop, wop. You got it.
Notice how I was by myself and then everybody decided to come bother me.
Oh, look who's coming. So I knew I wanted at least to do the wop, wop, wop. I want to do this because it was funny. Ducati, stop it.
Don't mind my son. He's very curious. So I'm going to go stand by his stepdaddy.
There we go. Y'all recognize him. And then the third move I definitely wanted to get in was the one where I was on the floor like this. But I didn't have like a smooth transition to get on the floor. So I thought, once I did all of this, I would try and like fall. Now, I don't know, maybe some of y'all noticed, I thought that it looked staged and it was. Some of y'all believe it, so it's whatever. So this is how it goes. You got thrown up and you got to accentuate everything because something I learned is that stupid is what makes everything look good. So if you feel like you look stupid, you're doing it right. So I hit this hard. Throw it up, pick it up, whop! Aggression, you need some aggression. Pick it up, whop. Turn around, make it shake. Pretend you fell on the floor. Get back up. Your head's gotta turn. I know my hood didn't show that. Head gotta turn. Whop, 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 my wig. So you're here, and then you're trying to dip. Pick it up, whop, aggression, whop. Turn around, make it shake, and here comes wop, 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 wop. And then this is where I improvise the whole time. Now, of course, I purposely got in front of him to make sure that my son don't touch the camera no more because he's afraid of him a little bit. So horse ended up being here. I was on the other side, but pop, bit like this hot. Take my knee. I slide with it. I slide. And then I ended up on the floor because low-key, I was very tired. And I got here. I was like, I can do this. Wop, 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 wop. Get on my knees. I was a South Central baddie, more like Central California. And I get up. I get up. I bring like James Brown. And that's all you got to do. Wop.
You ain't coming correct, nigga, you blocked. You about to slide in these panties, nigga, you not. You was in it for the pussy, I was in it for the guap. I'ma teach you how to play a nigga like an Xbox. I'ma teach you how to play a nigga. I'ma teach you how to play a nigga.
These bitches too fucking old to be acting like this. She almost 40, acting like a little bitch.
She rock her hips, then wave and dip. She rock her hips, then wave and dip. She rock her hips, she rock her hips.
So, are we going to be using one of your horses?
y'all. That's my baby mama right there.
Quit bothering us. This is mommy and daddy time.
That's so terrifying. This is all I saw out here. Stop it!
Kids always want what mom and dad got. Oh my, like, this was supposed to be our thing. Yeah, let your mama eat her stuff. Cotty, let your mama eat her stuff.
Catch me in a hood near you in a spaceship. Got back from Brooklyn, yo, they came my day trip. New bae from Chirac, that Bentley adjacent. Bitch wanna act up, you dead in my basement. Only smoke is out of any city that I go to. Yes, I am patient, my chopper do voodoo. You're now a zombie, your homies could die to your bitch sucking dick in the back with my whole crew. Her name was Billy, but now she a bop. Your nigga would pay me to just give me top. Said you a rapper, I said you a fuck. You said you a shooter, the hood say you not.
Swag, swag, girl, scream my name when I free boy, swag.
Soldier,
get out the way. Pretty boy coming through. Me and my crew, we swagging in the room. Girls on me.
You play too much. Now if I get into it with them, I got to live here and you don't. Don't be getting it, you gonna get me in trouble.
Me and my niggas tryna get it, you bitch. Yeah, bitch.
I was gonna go to class before I got high.
Come on. Why you think everybody back here is so chill?
I could have cheated and I could have passed.
My bad, bro.
But I got high.
I'm left today.
I have some really tiny chickens. Now this is like the average size egg y'all will get at the store, right? And then on average, my chickens make an egg about this big. You can see it's a little small, but not too big of a difference. Now I have one named Chentro, and she is not my star performer. And maybe on average, she'll create an egg about this size. Not too shabby. Let me show y'all what Chentro has made for me today. Now, real talk, I'm glad that she's just a pet, otherwise the family would starve.
All these bitches rocking inches cause they following the leader. I should switch it up on hoes and rock the apple like Lupita. I go hard in the booth, Biggie vibes, give me the loot. I'm a classy millionaire, bitches ain't got the coup. C-O-U-T-H cause you can't spell it either.
I just learned the full term of a horse's pregnancy is 340 days.
You ain't even know the half of it. For y'all that don't know, my name is Dezmineann and I am my horse's baby. Ducati, get out the frame. Get out the frame. You blocking my sunlight. Get out the frame. Hi, I'm civilized. Yeah, I am the baby daddy to my baby mama. Show her. It's about time. Getting all up in my personal space is my firstborn son, and there's my second son right there, that little brown one. Yeah, the reason why I'm the baby daddy is because they original daddy is a little nasty deadbeat. Like you mentioned, a horse's pregnancy lasts almost over a year. And let me tell y'all something real quick. It is just like human pregnancy, except so much worse, and not just because it's longer. Pregnant people get cravings, right? She gets like 34 pounds of it a day. Your body and your ankles be swollen. It hurts to walk. You going, ow, ow, ow. Horses are so terribly designed that any little foot abnormality, legs be hurting, don't want to work no more. Pregnant people also tend to get a little bit sick, you know, have some tummy trouble. Again, horses are so badly built from evolutionary stuff that if they get any type of tummy trouble, it's another app for me. I'll tell you what, it was a very stressful time bringing these two nasties into the world. It was a very long 3 or 4 years because she had them back to back. Because guess what? She went back to that man after I told her not to, but they always want to go back after your girl said no. Despite all that, we make a beautiful family, don't we? Yeah, baby mama's back there. It's my turn to watch the kids. I haven't been here in a week. He wasn't my favorite goat, but my favorite goat name was LeVar Tyrone Turuk Makto Washington. This is literally the only picture I have of him on my phone. Yeah, I got a lot more. I dedicated
full-length music videos, sometimes dual music videos, because I had that many memories of them, just to remember them by. But this is LeVar. First name LeVar, after LeVar Ball, because he was really popular during this time, and I haven't caught up with him lately. I hope that's nothing too crazy, but at that time, he was the GOAT. Tyrone, because I was listening to a lot of Erykah Badu. That was literally it. Turuk Makto comes from Avatar, because at that time I like had this weird resurgence of like really liking Avatar. I don't know about right now. But yeah, if y'all don't know or don't remember, Turuk Makto was that big old banshee that had, I think he had some type of like spiritual element to him. I don't know. He was the biggest and the baddest, and I was like, yep, that's my little LeVar. And then the Washington comes from me, the GOAT. And yeah, he's dressed like this. I started a trend over at my fairgrounds, but the Boondocks, Mr. Medicinal, 18 minutes, 30 seconds in.
I'm gonna tell y'all a story that I've been kind of reluctant to talk about because it's about a friend of a friend, but because I was physically there for a lot of it, I feel like I have a right to share it. Thing one is my best friend, and then thing two and thing three were his childhood best friends who were also his roommates at the time. Now, thing two had this ugly backyard built bred husky. Now, she was super sweet, but she was very untrained, and being ugly was not helping her case. And then thing three also had like this German shepherd healer mixed dog, male dog, but this dog is aggressive. I don't know if he's actually physically like for real bit somebody. I know he's mouthed my hand before when I walked in, but very aggressive dog. Now both of these dogs are walking around unaltered, and these three just freshly 20 year old boys thought that at least if they kept an eye on them, you know, they're not gonna breed, they're not gonna have puppies. Since their place was two bedroom, thing one was sleeping in the living room and he woke up to screaming.
But the whole topic of e-collars is something for another day.
I'm gonna say something and it has absolutely nothing to do with what the creator is talking about, but I do hope you don't mind that I'm using your video for my little purposes right now. There's been a lot of dog training videos on my For You page lately, and the way that these dogs be giving the trainer their most undivided attention gives me the friggin' ick. And it's not even in the way that y'all be thinking. My animal of choice is a horse, and those have only been domesticated for 5,000 years versus a dog where it's like, what, 300,000 years? That's why dog is man's best friend. They seek out human attention versus a horse where it's like, yeah, I could come over there, but I probably won't. See, I like that. I like that because I'm very like, keep your distance, but I do want to keep you close, but like, I'm gonna do my own thing, but like, you know, we still gonna be together versus a dog. Oh my gosh. And I've seen dogs before. I've seen dogs where they do not care about people, and I've seen dogs that are like, humans are my life. But it's just, I don't know if it's like a subculture or if like this really is what dog training's about or this is like what y'all want. I can't do it. I use this creator's video specifically because it provided the most perfect example. You notice how that dog eye contact not being broken is pushed up against the owner. I see his nasty little booty, nasty long ass saliva, nasty ass little tongue just out and flopping, putting his little nasty saliva of nasty flaps everywhere. And then they're like pressed up against the trainer, and I see not only the saliva, I see dirt from probably that animal, and then the hair sticking to it. And then I'm used to most people's dogs be smelling like butt cheeks, so it's just like, I think about it, like if I had a horse that I had to train and it never broke eye contact with me and it was stuck by my side the entire time, I would kid you not, I would just stop the whole session as its trainer and just look at it like, don't you got a life you want to get back to? Y'all better saddle up because I'm finna take y'all on a get ready with me to this roundup. But before we go here, we gotta start at the house. Now I got this bougie cow horse who thinks that just because he works with cows doesn't mean that he's gotta smell like one. And that goes for me too, because I represent him as his rider, his caregiver. So I gotta make sure I don't stank. Now I would share with y'all what kind of hair products I use, but since we saw what happened to Miel and countless other black hair products, yeah, no, I gotta gatekeep that because I'm gonna need some of these black hair products to stay working for our black hair.
Sorry about it. Usually my hair is ready to go, but I slept in a fro last night and I just woke up looking wild in my bonnet. So yeah, I just had to tame it just a little bit. For breakfast, I'm gonna have a little bit of oatmeal and some water. No, I do not put anything in it because as I have learned, cowboys are not allowed to have nice things. And since I am one, yeehaw. Today, we're not gonna work on our cattle on our Don Pedro property, but we're actually gonna help out a friend. Excuse me? Are you not an influencer? That's better. Now, we're gonna go help out a friend. He's got some calves that he needs to go take to market. And so me and a couple other old dudes are gonna go help him. And here comes my delicious, y'all can't see the air quotes, breakfast. Since a lot of y'all keep mentioning me how cowboys should have the bottom of the barrel at all times in every aspect of their lifestyle. And the only way that y'all would believe that I actually am one is if I follow suit. Girl, you know what's hot. Anyways, I need to go warm up my 2001 F-150 with over 300,000 miles on it. Yeah, kind of waiting for him to on me, but I'm having fun with him. I'm also keeping it cute. Like, I got my purple fuzzy dice and my Lisa Frank-style fluffy steering wheel cover and my license plates frames. Do I possibly want something bigger? Maybe. I'm debating. I'm a pony girl. I don't think I need too much truckage to be hauling all these little ponies. It's gonna be cold, so I got my Fashion Nova jacket, but like I said, it's gonna be cold, so I'm also need my daddy's little work jacket. Look at me. Look how fresh I am. Ooh. Ah. Ooh. Now, unlike the Grinch, I actually need to go where I need to be, so we gotta head out. Now, my grandpa initially said be here by 8:45. Not we leaving at 8:45. So I'm just sprinting early in the morning. Yep, there goes my bougie little cow horse. Got to get him all dolled up. Got his little bridle. Got my rope. So now I look like a real one. He did end up stepping on me after he slipped getting into the trailer, which I don't blame him, but it was an omen to the start of a bad day. It's beautiful up there. That property is amazing. But there's always something going down that incredibly inconveniences everybody. And I'm just not for that. I'm not built like that. Like these houses that got swept away by the levee. I'm so sorry, y'all. I am so sorry, incredibly, though.
Hold on. Now, before I address that, I just gotta say something. Some of y'all need to take the bass out your voice. Cause it could just be me. But some of y'all, it seems like y'all want me to feel stupid. I don't know too much about people, but we kind of ballpark it that a person is pregnant for about 9 months, right? Do we also know that they can be overdue? Now, what Jazz has informed y'all was 340 days. Now, if you subtract 10 days, that's 330. That's 11 months. Horses typically carry 11 months. But horses can also be overdue. My baby mama, Dakari, carried our son, Ducati, for about 342 days. I was gonna say something about Shango. I honestly don't know how long she carried him because, ooh, this is bad coming from a daddy, but his birth was very memorable. He was born in between lockdown and the California Butte fires. Give me a friggin' break. I personally know other horses who've carried healthy babies from 360 days to 375 days. 380 is the cutoff, and right when you get to or beyond that point, kind of when we start panicking. 340 days is like an approximation, where 330 to 380 days is more of like a ballpark. But I'm not gonna lie, I still feel a certain type of way because I think some of y'all really wanted me to feel stupid on my own video. I know y'all didn't have this information earlier, but it's just like, I can't help but feel like,
sneeze on that ass, sneeze on that ass, sneeze on that ass.
All over here nitpicking my words, talking about that's not even almost over a year. That's like a year or just under a year. You know what? Your mom is almost a year.
Oh, throwing hundreds in the air. We don't throw fans. Left, right.
Oh, lady, right.
I need an eater that's gonna eat it up. Bend it over, watch me beat it up. Watch, she gonna tear it up. Let me see you tear it up.
Oh, tear it up.
Let me see you tear it up. Blow her on me, they not scaring us.
How you wanna fuck with a star? You ain't even got no tinted windows on your car. They geeking when they see me. They don't know who you are. The show finna start. Put this bitch in park.
I just realized I am so fake. I am being so fake to y'all. And I'm serious. Like, this is not clickbait. I swear, I'm so friggin' fake. For years, y'all have seen this image of me being this person
who always puts her horse's wants and needs first, because hell fucking yeah, I'm gonna keep doing that shit. But I was sitting here just thinking about Ducati, like he was just on my brain, and I was like, I honestly want him to do so many things. Like, he's a rope horse, he's my trick horse, I'm getting him into driving, I want him to learn some dressage principles, I want him to learn how to play basketball. I'm like, dude, these are all things I want him to do. These are all things I want him. These are, like, I'm living vicariously through my child right now. That's what I'm realizing. Because, like, what if he wants to be a mailman?
Now, sis, what's the motto?
What's the motto?
Worry about the stash and tomorrow. If he ain't call you back, that's okay.
Just get his best friend on the dial.
Hanging in the bay with my girlies, we be all chill. Self-made little mama, but you know the drill. You know the drill. I ain't never been a fraud, always keep it real.
You ready? Damn, what that nigga like?
No shade to them, but I'm gonna talk about y'all, because they can compete in costume and it's all fine and dandy, but I can't dress like this and still be considered a cowboy.
Here we back on that bullshit. Every time that we fight, it's some new shit. Sick and tired, think it's time to get a new bitch. Damn,
that's gonna hurt you.
What's a rumor about an animal that's not actually true?
Ooh, I'm not skipping out on this one. So, horses can't conceptualize what respect is. That is a complex human construct. And unfortunately, and unbeknownst, when equestrians be talking about they need to gain respect from their horse, it roughly translates to they train their horse in fear. Their horse is afraid of them. And what sucks even more is that there are some people that are like totally aware of this, but they're not gonna change their ways, because why care about the animal's happiness now when it's yielding the results that you want? And I know you've seen all the money these people be winning. You think they gonna change that for animal happiness? And some of y'all gonna be upset with what I said, but take it from the experts, the doctors, the scientists. Don't come to my house.
Once upon a time in California, where they live life fast and they scared of dog. There was a little by the name of Chris. Nobody paid him any mind, no one gave a shit.
That video is a perfect time lapse for showing how horses gray out, or in my words, start off as beautiful, black, brown, dark, skinted, into white. Because a lot of y'all were asking me about my grandpa's coon horse, about like what were his before pictures. He didn't change much from this, because we only had him for a couple years. This is more like a 10-year type of span process. I mean, look, I don't even like him because he switched up on us. This is the only picture I have him in my phone. Y'all look at me. I look delicious.
I just found out what the cowboy hat rule was.
So did I, but let me tell y'all something. I didn't regularly wear a cowboy hat until like my junior year of high school. And that's because as a little working cowgirl, yes, I am a actual still active working cowgirl. Yes, I know. It's so hard to believe. But back then when I was working with these 50, 60-year-old men with my grandpa, they'd be like, oh, let's put the cowgirl hat on Dez. Now she's a real one, you know, real cute and sweet, aside from the actual cowboy hat rule. But I remember they was just nasty and sweaty because, you know, we're working out there. It's hot outside. And so fast forward to today, when I learned about the cowboy hat rule, I was just like, that's so friggin' nasty. Y'all in a dance hall. Y'all like actively moving more than us. And y'all giving y'all hats to strangers? That's so gross. And I think I was hate crimed when I was. No bullshit. I just tried to get off my horse, and guess where she ended up in?
I wanted her to stop here. She stopped right there.
What makes you think that you could go inside like that?
Christian, how old is Gunner supposed to be?
13?
Yeah, that sounds about right. His horse is 13. Mine is 16 right now. Look how youthful she is. Look how delicious and... Zoom out. Zoom. Look how delicious and nutritious she is. So I don't know why they think she just... She just... Does she give off... Does she give off the vibe of old and crusty? Because honestly...
The vibe of cranky.
Because he looks old and crusty. He's gray. My horse is youthful and vibrant and brown. I don't... I think Grandpa low-key hating. I think he found out about my head cannon. At least we look good.
He say that I'm good enough, cover my thudder. Think about shit that I shouldn't know. So I tell him it's one of me, he making fun of me. His girl is a bum to me, like that boy is a cap. Saying he home but I know where he at. Like, bet he blowing her back. Think about me cause he know that it's fat.
Okay, like bills on me blue, like a bruise, better yet, blues crunch. Bills on me blue, like a bruise, better yet, blues crunch. Bills on me blue,
Days with Roz. He literally just pecked the french fry out of this thing. Watch out. I gotta go. Look. This is me trying to move, and I'm trying to usher him away by using these splint boots. Look at him. See, if you just ducked where you usually hide, we wouldn't be having this problem, which is that way. See, now you're making me be the villain. Watch out. Watch out, Roz. There you go. Go back. See, that's exactly where you hide. That's always where you hide. Look at him. Look at him, scared. Look at, Chidori. Look at your man. Look at your man, Chidori. Don't look at your children. I'm about to take those. But look at your man. Hiding behind you. Yeah, that's right, Chidori. You better tell him. You better tell him that you done with him abusing you. You done with him treating you like trash. It ends today. It's a new day today. Today is...
Because I would love to just exchange energy with a few cows right now. Do I gotta be a special type of bitch?
I was just making sure that you knew that this is what you were looking for.
I'm a model, and I walk runway. Am I good at it? No. Do I get coaching for it? Nah, not that either. But I do be practicing. I be practicing a lot, because if y'all didn't know, if you walk runway, listen to me, if you walk runway, you have to serve. It is mandatory. Now, personally me, I'm new to serving. I'm probably like a year in, because honestly, growing up, I didn't think I was pretty enough to even like attempt to serve. Like, I thought, you know what, I'm just gonna fill in the funny role, and I was cool with that. I'm cool with that. But with this occupation, that's not gonna slide. So when I be out here in the backyard, I'd be practicing. When I go to model castings, I'd be serving. But then once it comes showtime and someone decides to film my walk and send it to me, I just... Let's talk about it real quick. Now, I never said this out in public on the internet. I did go see Nope. Beautiful, fantastic movie. I'm never gonna see it again. And that's just cause I have a cute little bunny girl heart. I could not handle all that, but it was a beautiful movie. Now, like I said, I never said this out on the internet, but I am waiting for Jordan Peele and his team to bring me my money, because I know darn well that they was using me as a template for Emerald. There is no freaking way they did not see me. Now, I don't wanna say too much, cause I don't wanna ruin my chances to my bag, cause you know, some legal stuff maybe, I don't know. I'm not used to all of this. People just wanting to, you know, be me. I've never been impersonated before. I'm honored a little bit, but I don't know what to do with myself. Honestly, you should have just casted me in my own movie. The movie should have been called Desmond's Worst Nightmare, because not only did it frighten me, but y'all really got me messed up with how y'all use them horses. You know how expensive them little nasties are, and I found out what they was used for.
I mean, I'm honored Keke Palmer played me, but, you know.
Now, I like to laugh and giggle as much as the next person, but do I look like somebody that fell off?
Hold on.
I said, do I look like somebody that fell off? Do I resemble that type of person? I think I'm quite sturdy. I think I got it. Because I can do this because I got shorts underneath. Do I look like somebody that can fall off? Twyla, get back over here. Come here, I need to prove points. Come here. I give my animals freedom. They have the freedom to leave and do stuff. But yeah, do I look like...
See, this right here is exactly what I be talking about. I be seeing y'all out here because I notice a lot of horse people are into competition. They see all these big accounts with these big hits and these horses doing fancy things or whatever, and they're like, I want to be the biggest name in this type of competition, which is okay. Competition is cool. But may I suggest looking like a complete idiot? Maybe a complete idiot is a little bit too strong. That's only for the veterans out here. But I think y'all would find a lot more fun, a lot more peace of mind, a lot less breakdowns if you choose fun over the competitiveness. Yes, this is a barrel race, but you're racing with a draft horse. The draft ain't gonna win, but you gonna have fun regardless. Imagine you in a NASCAR race, but you out there whipping a semi. You don't think that's gonna be fun? You don't think people are gonna not remember you and think you cool for doing that? I'm be ghost riding. I'm finna gas break. Smoke my butt, quit smoke my. Y'all playing with me, right? No tea, no shade to either of the twins, but I'm gonna talk about y'all real quick. Y'all got me out here making full-length music videos, twerking with these horses, who are wearing wigs, by the way, and they all have an individual backstory on how they are connected to me familially, how they're queer, and how they black. And I rarely get to touch anywhere near a million views. And y'all telling me I just had a cough? I truly thought we were all afraid of coughing. Like, y'all into horror? Is that what I'm hearing? I'm not a horror type of girl, but there was also a time where I said I was never gonna be a good dresser.
I do be lying to myself sometimes.
Get ready to type a bunch of words that y'all don't know onto Twitter, cause I'm finna.
You a coon, I don't like you.
Hi there, excuse me, I'm so sorry, but I'm having a moment and I just need some nodding of the heads. Yes. Why do my grandparents think that my horse is old as hell? Like, today my grandpa asked me, like, I gotta make some big girl decisions. I mean, he ain't wrong, I really do. But he was like pointing to my horse. He was like, yeah, and your mare there, you know, she's gonna start getting up there, you know, and you wash that leg of hers. She's 16. She is 16 years old, and she does have a lameness issue that we're addressing, but why do they think she's so old? And I'm not saying, like, they think 16 is an old age. They think 25 is old. They're that kind of people. I'm just like, y'all keep thinking she way older than she is, because they say this obviously ain't the first time. Like, my grandma has asked me twice now, considering my horse, like, other decisions I need to make. She's like, well, yeah, you know, Dakari, you know, she's like, what, 20, 22? You mean 14? She was 14 at that time? Does she look old to you? Do she look like a grandma? You know, head canonically, that's not a bad idea. Now, in my head, she's a little octo, but I guess, yeah, that would make sense. Because if she's an octo, that means there's not enough black to stop it from cracking. That might be a good idea. Thank you for talking to me.
You know, if my horses had the power to communicate with me, but it was like some big secret, like they just can't let people know that they can understand them, I would keep that secret. Like, I would keep it four hooves down, because I would be so much more preoccupied with trying to use that power to try to make them their happiest, because they honestly really do deserve it. And I do mean literally anything to make them happy. Like, even my own little son. Like, my son could come up to me and he could be like, "Daddy," and I'm gonna be like, "Hmm." And he gonna be like, "Daddy, I want you to dye me purple because I think that if I'm all purple, that is when I'm gonna be my happiest." And he is gonna be in that salon getting that opas on him and everything. He gonna be bright purple. And then when people ask me why I got a bright purple horse, I'm gonna just say, well, it's because it makes him happy. And I can say that because people already think I'm crazy, so they just be thinking that I'm talking or whatever. But, you know, I'm not lying to them, but it all works out in the end. But yeah, I'll do anything to make them little nasties happy. Now, if my son gonna come up to me and be like, "Daddy, I want to rob a bank." Now, that's where I'm gonna have to slow my roll, because first of all, I'm gonna have to explain to my son about these different types of human constructs that he doesn't know about. For starters, horses don't know what banks are.
Now, I don't know who I need to slap, but just get in the truck. Go get in the truck, Christian. Get in the truck, Christian. Get in the truck, Christian. Yeah, no, start making noise and moving. Right when I get started, get in there. All right, so I do know who to slap on that one, but I don't know who to slap because for y'all that haven't been around me for over the years, I am not what you would consider a conventional cowgirl, cowboy, cow person. I mean, this was not the outfit to prove to y'all about that, but just go through my feed. You know, this ain't normal. I've been said, I grew up in this lifestyle. Over the years, it's all been yeehaw. We got the cattle ranch. We got the rope horses. They're all retired team ropers, and they help out at our cattle ranch. And I facilitate all of that, and I do all the veterinary stuff. But for some reason, I'd be hopping on the internet, and people are like, "Oh, you're not a real cowgirl, cowboy, cow person, because this is what you look, this is what you do, you don't compete, you don't do this." I'm just like, disrespectfully. A lot of y'all been told me to not even give these people my energy, but you gotta think about it. As someone like me, take a nice good look at me. Yeah, I'm a nice person, but people will say mean things to me just for existing. So just look at me and think about all the types of sly, slick things people could say about me. Yeah, so I wanted to do this big push to be like, you know what? I don't care. I'm gonna put the tags cowgirl. I'm gonna always, because that's what I am. That's what I do. That's what I'm gonna be. So I'm gonna get recognized as that. So why in the search bar they got me as cow? How come my search bar is cow? It's not cowboy, it's not cowgirl, it's not even cow grandma. So because that happened, I would like that whoever is responsible for that for happening to repay me in some way. Fix the search bar, send me money. I'm so sick of you, Christian. I'm about to beat your ass.
Daddy.
Yes.
Why do you wear a helmet when you're up to bat playing baseball?
So the ball don't hit me. If it hit me in my head, I don't get knocked out.
Well, what if I told you it's just because you're afraid of baseball?
What if I tell you you're right? And it's that part right
there. So why do you wear a helmet for football?
I thought it was originally to protect your head. Get smacked around by pads.
What if I told you it's because you're afraid?
Afraid of who?
I don't know, like your teammates? You're afraid of your teammates, so you wear a helmet for football.
How does that work?
That's what I've been told. Wear the helmet and you're afraid of the baseball. Does that mean that you're not trustworthy of the pitcher?
No, I don't trust the pitcher.
You don't trust the pitcher?
No.
Never. Why?
Because the pitcher can make a mistake. Or if I hit a hard base. Say I'm trying to throw this.
Yeah.
At the garbage can.
Yes.
Somebody just slipped and throw it over here and hit mom in her ear.
Yes.
With the spatula.
Slice my eye open.
No, her ear. Then her hair go flying in here, then I have a spatula in here, and then she's upset.
Okay.
So, same thing happened to the ball. Come out of his hand. He's trying to throw it straight, but it comes out from up here, and I'm like this. And by the time I go like this, my reaction already got a ball coming fast at me, 80-something, 90-something miles an hour. Ah!
afraid of my teammates because I wear a helmet. Negative.
So it's a safety thing.
Yes.
To protect your head.
Yes.
Because that's important.
Yes.
And if you get any type of like, you know, head trauma, damage, whatever, that's a pretty life-threatening, almost big deal, huh?
Yeah, you don't want to get to it.
I'm glad you...
I've hit people in the head before.
I heard.
And it hurts.
Yeah.
And it's a mistake.
And they wore a helmet, huh?
Yes.
Because they're afraid of baseball.
Yes.
So they should stop playing baseball because they're afraid.
No. Some of these dudes get wrists broken, fingers broken, shins broken because of the ball came in and hit them.
Uncle died for not wearing a helmet.
Everybody who has sense wears one.
Wear helmets. The bicycle racers, they wear helmets.
But they're afraid of their bikes.
Skateboarders, what do they wear when they're on the team?
When they're in the Olympics and all that, yeah.
They wear helmets.
Helmets.
And they're doing stuff that nobody's going to do, where people really are scared to do. They're doing it. They're flipping and jumping with helmets on, and that's don't stop them from breaking a rib, breaking them. You're supposed to wear a helmet. Only idiots don't wear helmets. Why would I wear a helmet to protect my head so I can do something later on? I can go do what I love doing and hope this helmet keep me from losing, not busting my head and shaking my brain or something.
You right.
Making my brain bleed.
Yeah.
If somebody, if I get in a fight, I wish I had a helmet on.
You right.
Go ahead and hit that helmet. I'll keep fighting.
Shut up. Okay. Reason I had to say that is because I had a lot of little nasties get on my butt about this.
I'ma be honest here, where none of my sisters chose to do sports. That was something that my dad kind of like pushed upon us because it's kind of like a pull up your bootstraps type of black thing. I think y'all get it, but we do not regret it. We love them sports. We do not regret it. But because it was pushed so heavily, because us doing well in sports was gonna set us up for life, get us to college, and set us up for careers, which it did. It did pay us off very handsomely. But like I'm saying, it wasn't our passion. So when we were kind of forced to do all these practices, or even worse for me, really, when we had to watch all these basketball games and study everybody and their movements or whatever, this man right here, he was never on any teams that we was rooting on, but we knew that he was a force to be reckoned with. My family didn't have money like that. Like, y'all see them horses? That's my grandparents. My family ain't got money like that. So I have never seen any basketball players, professional basketball players. I have never been to a professional game whatsoever. I went to my first Laker game like 1 or 2 months ago. And even though we were very high up, we were in the nosebleeds or whatever, we were watching the Sac Kings LA Laker game, I saw LeBron walk onto the court and I started crying. I wasn't like, but I was starting to tear up. Everybody was clowning me like, look at that. She out here getting all crying over LeBron. We're Warriors. We're Oakland. So yeah, there was like an anti-LeBron thing going on. But for me, I was like, shut up. Like I was in the beginning. Because all them years of me getting pushed, me watching this man, watching this celebrity, watching this force of nature, and I finally see him in front of me, how was I not gonna cry? How was I not going? He's my first celebrity I've ever seen. Yes, I live in California. I've not seen a celebrity. I'm the celebrity.
You're my son too. You have to be in my pictures with me, in my videos, so we can watch how we all grew up together as a family. I don't have anything. Ducati! Oh my God, let go! Ducati! You can't let your brother have one little moment with dad, can you? You just gotta be star of the show. Is this older sibling syndrome? What's going on with you? Because this ain't it. This is not happening for the next 20 years. I'm not having it. Don't. I'm not even playing. Stop. Don't even play that. Acting out. Rest on me. Now come and get high.